Introduction to the PPM300 Controller Rack. This video will provide you with an overview of the layout and features of the controller rack. The rack is an aluminium box which houses the different hardware modules. It's designed to be installed in an enclosure. The frame has hexagonal holes designed to improve cooling and electromagnetic compatibility. Each controller consists of a rack and a number of hardware modules. These are replaceable printed circuit boards and include power supply, control, and I/O interfaces. They communicate with each other through the rack backplane. Modules are arranged in the rack from left to right. Blind modules, which consist only of a blank faceplate, must be installed over any empty slots. When mounted, the rack frame must be grounded. The frame has four mounting brackets, two of which have position adjustment. A suitable ground connection must be made to one of the four brackets. The controller has cable strain relief plates mounted at the top and bottom for cable organization. The cable ties and routing must not block more than 20% of the ventilation. Slot number one is always allocated to the power and supply module PSM. The PSM 3.1 provides power for all the other hardware modules. The module manages the self-check status, and this is indicated by the LEDs. It also includes battery voltage measurement. If a processor and communication module is present, this will always be installed in slot number 7. It houses the main microprocessor for the rack, which contains and runs the application's software. It also contains the Ethernet switch, which controls and manages the 5 Ethernet connections. It also has 2 sets of CAN bus connections and houses the SD card. The other slots, 2 to 5, contain the other hardware modules for the controller rack. This can vary depending on the type of controller. The alternating current module, ACM 3.1, measures the current and voltage on one side of the breaker, and the voltage on the other. The module responds when the measurements exceed the AC protections. It uses the AC measurements to check the synchronization before the breaker closes. By default, it measures 3-phase systems. The input-output module, IOM 3.1, has 4 changeover relays and 10 digital inputs. These are all configurable. The engine interface module, EIM 3.1, is installed in the genset and emergency genset controller types. It has its own power supply and an MPU input to measure engine speed. It also has 4 relay outputs, 4 digital inputs, and 3 analog inputs. These are all configurable. The governor and automatic voltage regulator module, GAM 3.1, is installed in the genset and emergency genset controller types. It has 4 relay outputs, 3 analog outputs, and 2 analog inputs. These are all configurable. Each hardware module has numbered connectors for each of the different terminals. These can be removed for wiring and replaced afterwards. For more information, visit dife.com/documentation. Locate your product from the list and use Show Documentation for all of the information available regarding your product.